Hello students, hope you are doing well. Every year, the State Common Entrance Test Cell under the ambit of DT Maharashtra, that is Directorate of Technical Education, conducts Maharashtra B.Tech admissions. Through the admission process, the candidates are shortlisted for admission to B.Tech courses at numerous engineering colleges, universities and deemed universities in Maharashtra state. Apart from first-year B.Tech admission in Maharashtra, DT also conducts the admission process for second-year B.Tech courses through the lateral entry mode. If you are also planning to get admission to B.Tech program at Maharashtra, then it is very important for you to have the complete knowledge of the admission process before you apply for the admission. Hence, in today's video, we'll discuss all the important details pertaining to Maharashtra B.Tech admissions, such as admission, counseling, eligibility criteria, selection process, application process, etc. Maharashtra B.Tech admission dates. The candidates can check the video description for important dates for Maharashtra B.Tech admission, where they can find the complete schedule for the admission process. Now, let us look at the various exams that are accepted for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. The major entrance exam that is conducted for B.Tech admission in Maharashtra is the MHT CET exam. Note that candidates who are applying for state quota admission are required to appear for the MHT CET exam. The another exam which is accepted for Maharashtra B.Tech admission is the JEE Main exam. Although the candidates who have only qualified JEE Main exam and not the MHT CET exam will not be allowed for the state quota admission and will only be considered for the merit-based or the direct admission. Now, let us look at the eligibility for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. First, let us look at the eligibility for Maharashtra state candidates. The applicants must be citizen of India. The applicants must have passed class 12th with mathematics and physics as mandatory subjects. Apart from these two subjects, the candidates must have studied chemistry or biotechnology or biology in class 12th. The applicants must have acquired a minimum of 50% aggregate in class 12th with 45% for the reserved and PH categories. The applicants must have passed SSC and HSC or Diploma in Engineering from a recognized school or institution in Maharashtra state. The candidates whose father or mother is domiciled in Maharashtra are also eligible for admission. Note that these candidates must submit a domicile certificate. The candidates must have a non-zero score in MHT CET. The candidates who have pursued Diploma in Engineering course can also apply for second year B.Tech admission through the lateral entry scheme. Now, let us look at the eligibility for the non-domiciled candidates. The applicants must be citizen of India. The applicants must have passed class 12th with mathematics and physics as mandatory subjects. Apart from these two subjects, the candidates must have studied chemistry or biology or biotechnology in class 12th as the optional subjects. The candidates must have acquired a minimum of 50% of aggregate in class 12th, that is 45% for reserved and PH categories. The students from any state can apply for B.Tech admission in Maharashtra through the non-domicile category. The candidates must have a non-zero positive score in MHT CET. The candidates who have pursued Diploma in Engineering exam can also apply for lateral entry scheme. Now, let us look at the registration process for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. First, let us look at the registration process for centralized admission process, that is CAP, through MHT CET. All the aspiring candidates with a valid MHT score can fill the application form for B.Tech admission in Maharashtra through the official website of DT Maharashtra. The candidates can log in with the MHT CET login credentials to register for the CAP. The applicants with a valid JEE Main score must register on the official website and generate login credentials to submit online application form for CAP. After the successful submission of the online application form, the candidates must pay the CAP fee or the counseling fee. The candidates can also visit the facilitation centers to submit the online application form, upload relevant documents, and pay the counseling fee. Note that it is mandatory for the candidates to take the printout of the application form after the payment of counseling fee. Now, let us look at the registration or the counseling fee for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. For general categories, the fee is 800 rupees. For reserved categories, it is 600 rupees, while for the NRI or OCI or PIO categories, the application fee will be 5000 rupees. Now, let us look at the registration process for direct admission. The candidates who wish to get direct admission to B.Tech courses in Maharashtra will have to visit the official website of the respective college. The candidates can also visit the campus or fill the common application form of college deco at the given link for an easy and seamless admission. The candidates will also have to fill the application form along with all the required documents and pay the application fee. Now, let us look at the detailed Maharashtra B.Tech admission process step by step. The very first step is the preparation of merit list. All the eligible candidates who registered for the CAP will be assigned a merit number by the admission authority. The merit number is issued based on the candidate's performance in MHT CET entrance exam. All the aspiring candidates with a valid MHT score will have to further fill the application form for B.Tech admission in Maharashtra. The candidates will also have to pay for the counseling at the time of registration. The next step is the document verification. After submitting the online application form, the candidates must visit the nearest facilitation centers, which will be available on the official website, to complete their document verification process. The candidates must be present at the facilitation center with all the documents prescribed in the application form. It is also mandatory for the candidates to carry the printout of the application form for document verification. The next step is the release of provisional and final merit list. DT Maharashtra will display the provisional merit list of the candidates on its official website. The merit list just gives information on the relevant position of the candidates. The candidates in the merit list may or may not get admission, as the seat allocation process is completely based on order of the merit. The admission authority gives a merit number to the candidates. The candidates can also raise objection on the provisional merit list if they find any discrepancy. After sorting out all the issues and discrepancies, the DT Maharashtra will release the final merit list for B.Tech admissions. The next step is the seat allotment process, which will be done after the MHT CET counseling, which will be conducted in three rounds, that is CAP1, CAP2, and CAP3 round. Now, let us look at the step-by-step process for seat allotment for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. The very first step is the filling and confirmation of online option. After the release of final merit list, all the eligible candidates will be allowed to fill online option form on the official website. DT will release the list of colleges, B.Tech courses and seats on the official website, and the candidates will be allowed to choose a maximum number of options to improve their chances of admission. The candidates can fill a maximum of 300 choices. After choice filling, the candidates must confirm the option entry form. Once confirmed, the candidates cannot edit the same. The next step is the display of provisional allotment and final allotment. Based on the preferences filled by the candidates, MHT CET merit or order, or merit or previous academic record, the admission authority will release a provisional allotment list to give candidates an idea of their allotment. The next step is the CAP round 1, round 2 and round 3, which will be 3 rounds of Maharashtra B.Tech admission counseling. The next step is accepting or rejecting the allotment. If the candidates are allotted seats in a college as per their first preference in the option entry form, they'll have to report to the reporting center and confirm their admission. The candidates will not be allowed to take part in the subsequent rounds of CAP after accepting their allotment. On the other hand, if the candidates are not allotted seats as per their first preference, they'll have a chance to accept or reject the allotment. If they wish to reject the allotment, they can choose to take part in subsequent rounds of the admission process. The last step is reporting to the institute. After confirming the admission, the candidates must report to the respective engineering colleges with all the required documents. The college will then upload the admission details of the candidates on the server, and the admission process will complete after the fee payment. Now, let us look at the list of documents that are required for Maharashtra B.Tech admission for verification. Transfer certificate or school leaving certificate, class 12th mark sheet or pass certificate, class 10th mark sheet or pass certificate, MHT CET scorecard or JEE Main scorecard, domicile certificate for the domicile category candidates, category certificate for the reserved category candidates, physical disability certificate for the physical disabled category candidates, and income certificate for students applying under the tuition fee waiver scheme. Now, as per the policy prescribed by the Government of Maharashtra, there are various reservation policy for different category of candidates. Note that these reservation policy will only be applicable for the candidates who have the domicile of Maharashtra state, and all other state candidates will be considered as the general category. The seat reservation for SC category candidates is 13%, for ST it's 7%, for VJ, DT, NTA it's 3%, for NTB it's 2.5%, for NTC it is 3.5%, for NTD it is 2%, and for the other backward categories, that is OBC, it is 90%. Overall, 50% of the seat reserved categories for Maharashtra B.Tech admission. Now, let us look at the various B.Tech colleges in Maharashtra where the candidates can take admission into B.Tech programs. International School of Business and Media, that is ISBNM Pune, MIT University Mumbai, MIT Art Design and Technology University Pune, Ajinkya D.Y. Patil University Pune, Sandeep University Nashik, Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University Amravati, Professor Ram Mege Institute of Technology and Research Amravati, Sanmati Engineering College Vashim, Manav School of Engineering and Technology Nagpur, University Department of Chemical Technology Aurangabad, G.S. Mandal's Maharashtra Institute of Technology Aurangabad, and Deogiri Institute of Engineering and Management Studies Aurangabad. That's all for today. Thank you. For more information on B.Tech admissions, stay tuned to College Deco. You can also check the video description for other related articles to help you out. Meanwhile, you can also fill our common application form at the given link for admission related assistance. Thank you.
If you like this video, do like, share, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.